The first thing you do is to rent a car. You should pick up your car at the renter company's parking lot, not at the airport. Most companies are located in a 10-minute drive distance from the airport. You cross that crosswalk to get a shuttle bus. There is a place for tourists waiting for the shuttle bus. Many shuttle buses wait for the tourist here. It will get you the rental car office. Now I got on the Lotte rental car bus. The shuttle bus runs every 8 minutes. It takes 10 minutes from the airport to the office. You have to book for renting a car before you get off to travel. You can book for renting a car through the website. Lotte Rental, Tanma Rent-A-Car have an English website. To rent a car in Korea, a driver should be 21 years old or older. You need an international driving permit, a passport, and a credit card. A rental company offers a basic insurance which covers personal injuries, damages on third-party people, and property. But all damages of the vehicle during the rental period caused by a customer is the customer's responsibility. The collision damage waiver is an optional service which covers damages of the vehicle. If you worry about repair costs, you better add this optional insurance to your renter contract. Please take pictures of your vehicle when you pick up. To return, you have to refuel the vehicle as much as it was refueled at first. Okay, now you know how to rent a car. Let's drive out. Jeju Island is a unique place, holding the honor of the natural science area such as UNESCO World Biosphere Reserve, UNESCO World Natural Heritage Site, and UNESCO World Geopark Network. The provincial government set a goal that electric vehicles take over all transportation on the island in 2030. You can rent these Korean makers' electric vehicles such as Hyundai Kona and Kia Niro. They can drive over 400 kilometers at full charge. That's as much as you can drive for 2 or 3 days without charging. At first, change language to English. You can use a built-in GPS, which works well in English. To search places, press the navigation button under the screen. On the menu, press places, then you can type the address to search. With this GPS, you can search the locations of the charging station. At home menu, press the EV button, then you can check the battery state and near charging stations around you. You can find easily charging stations anywhere on Jeju Island. Here's how to charge your vehicle. At the charging station, please park your vehicle right before a charger. Kona is charged at the front, so park front side in. Until 80% of the battery charged, the charging speed is normal. But over 80%, it gets slower, so you better stop charging at 80%. When you start charging from 20% to 80%, it takes about 60 minutes. You can see three different types of cable. Each cable matches specific cars. Touch the start button on a screen to start charging. Next comes the screen for selecting the type of charging cable. A DC combo cable for Kona. Touch combo on the very right. Next, choose a payment method. Membership cards and membership card numbers are options. If the card doesn't work, enter the membership number written on the card instead. You get a charging card when you pick up the car. Place the card on a card recognition area under the screen. Then a box will open, then the charging cable can be moved. This is a plug of Kona. If you don't know which is right to your vehicle, you open the socket and compare them. Pull out the cable and press a cover on the vehicle to open it and put the plug to the vehicle. When charging starts, the lamp on the vehicle flashes, and the screen gives you information about the charging status. When charging is complete or you hit the stop button, the cables connected to the vehicle are released. For your safety in driving, I'll give you important information. We drive on the right side of the road with left-hand drive. Please keep paying attention to speed limits. The maximum speed is limited to 70 km per hour on roads in suburban area, 50 km per hour in downtown and residential areas, and 30 km per hour for children or senior citizens protection zone. In a roundabout, you can drive in a roundabout after cars turning inside, use it first. Please drive carefully, even if you are turning inside at roundabout, because these rules ignored quite often. There is a bus-only lane marked with a blue stripe on ground in Jeju City, including the airport. Bus-only lanes near the airport are under 24/7 control, and bus-only lanes across Jeju City are controlled at 7 a.m. to 9 a.m. and 4:30 p.m. to 7:30 p.m. only on weekdays. Please be careful not to drive on this road. And there is a rule about how you can overtake another car on the road. You should move to a first lane, which is the nearest to an yellow line at the center of the road. When you try to overtake through the first lane, please do not drive slowly there and return to the second lane again. For your information, I'll show some signs you could find easily on Jejuisland. This traffic sign is a warning sign to slow down because there is a speed bump ahead. Speed bumps are usually installed around children's or elderly protection zone, before roundabout, and in residential areas. This traffic sign is an alert sign indicating speed checking. If you are driving faster than the speed limit, slow down below the speed limit. And here's what you need to do after a car accident occurs. If someone hurts, call 119. It's a call for an ambulance. Turn on the hazard lights, install safety triangle at 200 meters behind your car. Record some footages on the damage you gave or you were given, and pull over the car to side. Call rental company, they will tell you how to do next.